Hello everybody, welcome back to another tutorial video. Today we will be handling 2D launchable projectiles. Ready? Let's go! For today's tutorial, we will be using the same world we set up in our previous tutorials. As with our other tutorials, all assets are naturally free. We will only be adding the bomb sprite today, for which I will leave a link in the description below. First, we are going to set up the prefab for our bomb. Let's simply create a new game object called Bomb and drag our sprite into it. A common mistake at this point is to forget to reset the position of the child object to 0, which will result in the sprite spawning at an offset. There are plenty of use cases for that, but we don't want that today. As for the components, we need a 2D circle collider that fits around our sprite. And we need a 2D rigid body. And let's add our projectile script to it. However, for the bomb, we want it to be thrown so it can go over obstacles. We will need to edit the projectile script to have only two more properties. The first is a boolean called thrown. And the second is a vector 3 called launch offset, since we don't want it to immediately explode in the character's face. That would be terribly inconvenient. The main difference to other projectiles is that this one will be fired in an arc. As such, we will let the 2D physics do the hard work. So let's get the 2D rigid body component and add a force. To keep the code readable, we should define a variable that will hold the direction in which we throw the projectile. And since our characters are left facing by default, let's use negative right direction plus vector3.up, which will give us a 45 degree forward upward angle. In the addForce function, we need to multiply the direction with our speed and be sure to use an impulse force. Take note, we only want to do this when it is a thrown projectile. The last thing we need to do here is call the transform.translate and pass our launch offset field. This will move our projectile before the physics is calculated. Finally, for this script, if it is a thrown projectile, we do not want to move it manually. We're almost done with the code. The only two things we still need to adapt is in the character controller, so that we can use both projectiles at once. This, however, is copy and paste work, therefore I don't think it needs much explaining. We will, however, use the fire 2 instead of the fire 1. This will allow us to right-click to throw the bomb. That's it. Let's head back to Unity. Alright, on our bomb, let's set it to be a thrown projectile, and for the offset, I've pre-calculated that it should be minus 0.1 for the x-axis and 0.3 for the y-axis. This will depend on your collider. If yours is bigger or smaller, you will need other values here. Play around with it until the bomb does not explode in your character's face. Drag down the bomb to the asset window to create a prefab. And drag the prefab into our character controller's launchable projectile prefab field. Fantastic, now let's explode some things. Boom, didn't even see it coming. Perfect. And done. You now know how to do 2D launchable projectiles in less than 5 minutes. Head over to Patreon to see how you can support free content like this. And don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and notification buttons to stay up to date with our 5-minute tutorial series. Let us know what you think about this video in the comments below. Further, we're happy to answer any questions you may have about Unity on our Discord. And that's a wrap. See you in the next one.